My lab studies the molecular basis for drug resistance, and we're very interested in how drug resistance occurs at the molecular level, how a target evolves drug resistance, and the balance between how the target functions, how it carries out its biological process, and how drug resistance occurs at the molecular level when a new drug hits a particular target, how drug resistance occurs. We're studying mainly antivirals, so HIV, hepatitis C, influenza, but the lessons we're learning should be applicable to cancer, to some antibiotics, really across the board. In the work we've been doing initially on HIV, we actually define something we call the substrate envelope. And the substrate envelope is the overlapping volume of the different substrates that HIV protease recognized. What we discovered was that most resistance occurred right where the inhibitors protruded away from where the substrates bound. And that made a lot of sense because those sites that were where the inhibitors were sticking away from the substrates were sites that were more important for inhibitor binding than for substrate recognition and turnover. We use this to develop, to design and actually make new compounds that could potentially be very potent antivirals. They're more potent than any drug on the market right now, binding with picomolar affinity. But we've taken that now a step further, and we've done the same kind of thing with the hepatitis C protease. And again, we solved crystal structures of substrate complexes, looked at how they bound, and then looked at how the inhibitors bound. Right now, the pharmaceutical industry has invested more than $15 billion in developing these new protease inhibitors for hepatitis C. I mean, 200 million people are infected with hepatitis C worldwide. So, it's a huge, huge pandemic. And so we need better drugs. And these drugs are giving us hope. If we could make drugs that had less, were more robust, that's a word I like to use, that they're more robust so they're less susceptible to drug resistance by being a little smarter about how we do the drug design. I mean, we're not going to get around evolution. Drug resistance is eventually going to arise, but we can make it tougher by being smart about how we do it. And right now, drug resistance isn't part of the drug design process. It's more of an afterthought rather than in the very initial stages from the get-go. And so that's what we're trying to do.